So, yeah, been a long time. Cue that.
And it's time to cast the cares that we have on our mind. Let's go.
Hey, what's up? Everybody out there, it is Ryan here, your host of Casting Cares, where we look to encourage and increase your faith in Jesus Christ. Now, if you like what you see in here, and if it's your first time here, please consider subscribing. Click that little bell for notifications so that you don't miss any of my videos. Smash on that like button and most definitely share this video. It's about time that the gospel get out to the world for real. So I won't be too long today. I just have one thought that's been on my mind for quite some time. Been wanting to record it, but I really just have not found the time to get back to you guys. And I apologize deeply about that. But I want to sort of kind of piggyback on a episode that I did when I first started this thing. It was about friendships. I'll put that link in the description below. If you want to go see that, I implore you, please go do so. But that last one was basically talking about, you know, when I first come into this thing, when I first start my walk with Christ, should I keep the old friends that I used to have? But this is sort of kind of piggybacking off of that. And this is talking about what kind of friends should I have even when I'm in the church. Hey, just like in the world, even in the church, there are some friendships that can be toxic. But I want to use a little bit of the Word of God to help you out with that. So here we go. The most vulnerable victim in the Old Testament in the times of the kings was Amnon. And it wasn't like Amnon was just this terrible person. He just had this urge that he couldn't control, right? And so when we normally have urges like that, it behooves us to seek wise counsel. Unfortunately, this brother had a homeboy. And even more unfortunately, we have homeboys, homegirls, etc. But Amnon's friend's name was Jonadab, and this brother, he was terrible. The Bible even starts off by calling him subtle. And that's bad considering the fact that the Bible also calls the devil subtle. But Amnon had this uncontrollable urge to be with his sister Tamar. But instead of pointing him in the right direction like Jonadab should have done, Jonadab puts together this crazy concocted plan for Amnon to get Tamar alone. And I'm gonna make a long story short by saying it didn't end well for either of them. We know Tamar got raped and all of that, and she happened to have a brother named Absalom, and Absalom happened to be one evil dude, and it didn't end well for Amnon because Absalom went in on him. But here is the problem to me. The problem is that Amnon actually allowed Jonadab to give him advice. He didn't happen to look how Jonadab's life was going. He didn't pay any attention to the characteristics of his friend. He just, without question, listened to him. And here is the most alarming part to me. After everything was said and done, because this is actually the thing that started Absalom's quest to take over the entire kingdom, because he did not like the way that David had dealt with the entire situation. After it was all said and done, Jonadab basically disappeared. He said like a couple more things. There's like a couple more scriptures about him. And then you don't hear nothing from Jonadab anymore. I mean, nothing. Y'all, I'm telling you, some people will come into our lives and will tear our lives up. And then when we looking around, they will be gone. Y'all, the devil places certain people in the church, will allow you to befriend them and will allow them to do you dirty and destroy the entire church in the process. And then like that, gone. So I say to you, please look well to your goings, Look at your friends. See what kind of friends you are making in the church. Make sure that you guys are like-minded, that you have the same goals in mind, that they'll help you reach your goals and that you can help them reach their goal. And know this, that even sometimes when you do feel lonely, there is a friend that sticks closer than a brother. Y'all, that's it. Y'all, I love y'all in Jesus' name. Y'all take it easy till next time.